Tonight, it's the Carolina Hurricanes who will provide the opposition, the 24th preseason meeting between these two teams. And Todd Reardon getting ready for preseason game number 5. And I know, Craig, it's just the preseason, but he'd like a victory at some point, right? You see?
Is it much?
I'm not safe.
Stats from last year, the Capitals penalty kill 15th in the league. Hurricanes were 22nd with a man advantage. Those stats package for you by the UPS store. And in front, they score. Nifty passing play. That is Svechnikov setting up in front with a beautiful pass as it is banged in. And right off the bat, we see the Capitals with Zekov, who was supposed to be a scratch tonight. Zekov comes in, and he gets the power play goal to put the Carolina Hurricanes up 1-0.
Well, when you look at both stats of both teams on the penalty kill and on the power play, both teams want to see improvement in that side of things, especially Carolina. So far now, 6-for-13 on the power play in the preseason.
As we get now 60 seconds remaining for the Capitals to work with the extra man. An errant pass that was read perfectly and knocked away by Hayden Fleury. Ends a shorthanded chance, backhand in, saved by Holtby, and then that hit the post as a chance coming back in the other side on the shorthanded situation by a defenseman, Brett Pesce. Defenseman Brett Pesce jumping up on the play.
And notice the play, look at Orlov. There's not much you can do when you're caught standing still and trying to move up on the play, and there's that opportunity.
You know, at some point, as we mentioned, with 10 of the 18 skaters tonight of their draft choices in one of the first three rounds of drafts, at some point, you think it's gotta pay off, right?
Yeah.
You keep drafting high, like Andrei Svechnikov, the second overall pick, and finally you may see something pay off. Now a deflection that goes in, a crazy carom in front. Braden Holtby had no chance against Jordan Staal, who may have scored the easiest goal of his career.
I think the Caps have maybe 12 draft picks in their lineup, so a lot of youngsters also, but that is, look what I just scored there. He'd rather save that probably for the regular season, right off his leg and pass to surprise Holtby. Again, a broken play, sharp angle shot. They keep it in. Notice the D jumping into the play, and there you see ricochet off the left side of Staal, who always seems to have great games against the Caps. Every Staal, by the way, yeah. Mark, Eric, and now Jordan, which he always does, and he's made his club go up 2-0.
They have been outscored 11-5 in the previous four outings.
And it's been their first period. Remember last night they were down 4-0, right? Now it's 2-0. They got to buckle down here.
Here's Aaron Ness trying to change it, and Nick Backstrom does. Off a perfect feed, the Caps are on the board, slicing the Hurricane lead in half.
Right on cue for Nick Backstrom. A nice one-timer, but a beautiful head fake and stick fake by Ness. And I'm really happy they signed this guy. He's a great guy to have within the organization. He has a lot of experience in the American Hockey League. And when he comes up, he doesn't miss a beat. That's beautiful. He doesn't even look at Nick Backstrom when he makes the pass. Watch where his head is. He's looking far side, and he throws it short side, which freezes the goaltender, and Nick Backstrom buries it.
Weaving in is Nick Backstrom. Couldn't get all the way through to Peter Mrazek, and again, an easy clear for the shorthanded Canes.
Left slingshot to Nick Backstrom on their breakout. We usually see it from Kuznetsov.
And they score off another turnover. We talked about what Jordan Martinuk did at the other end, this time off the turnover and working with Warren Fogle. They beat Braden Holtby. A shorthanded goal restores the 2-goal margin for Carolina.
Sloppy and more sloppiness on their power play. First of all, you miss a couple of plays there. Verana misses his man. Niskanen doesn't collect the puck cleanly because of the errant pass by Holtby. And all of a sudden, that little life they had, Fogle makes the Capitals pay, getting that pass to the front of the net, and Martinuk buries it.
The Hurricanes, a perfect 1-for-1 tonight, as the UPS store brings you these updated stats from the evening. Baxter will serve it, half Hamilton setting up on the front, and a beautiful save there by Braden Holtby, who saw that late as the defenseman actually parted just in time with Justin Falk. Lucas Walmark over Lucas Johansson, and another save there by Braden Holtby with a minute gone in the Capital extra man attack. Oshie the one-timer, and that rung off the post as he beat Mrazek, but found only iron. Beautiful setup. Can they get it down again? Orlov walks in, a wrister whistles high. May have got a piece of the glove of Peter Mrazek. Settle down again. Barber pushes his way past. Boyd comes in. That's Travis Boyd. And then it blocked off on a diving save there by Hayden Fleury. Now both sides will change up personnel as Ness is out of the box, so a good penalty kill ultimately for the Washington Capitals, but not out of danger yet. Another chance, and that again was Samsonov being ready for a wide shot that came blistering in from the wing. It is going to take a little while to understand, but he's got help from Orlov, Kuznetsov, Ovechkin. Shooting wide are the Canes as they continue to buzz in that Washington zone, getting good looks whether they connect or not. Second of the preseason, and from that point on, the Hurricanes really have not been dramatically tested. The Nick Backstrom tally, a power play goal at 12:21 of the first. The lone tally for the Capitals, who have now been outscored 14-6 in this preseason. Nedeljkovic with his best work there as the Capitals storm the net.
And all that was speed by Gersich going wide and flinging the puck at his pads, creating goals and goal opportunities by shooting and to make an offensive opportunity off the pads of the goaltender.
And it was Riley Barber looking for the rebound. Here they come again, 3-on-1. Gersich to Barber, broken up beautifully by Phil DiGiuseppe.
Have to be a little selfish there, come to the middle and rip it. Good opportunity, better defense from Carolina.
Here we go again with another Carolina power play to possibly close out this game. Another good test for the Washington Capital penalty killers as this Carolina power play has moved the puck around very efficiently tonight. They've cashed in on one of their chances. And here's Jordan Staal looking for his second of the night. And a backhand chance will go with Justin Williams getting it done. Zekov getting it done for his second of the night.
Well, their power play that they've probably been working on, it was the big boys out there to try to get that fourth goal. Slavin involved, everyone moving the puck, but it all starts on the left side with Williams forcing the puck to Staal. What a great pickup and shot. Now the right side of the screen, you'll see the D-man sneaking in, and Slavin goes to the backhand. Now, good collection of the puck. Watch the play coming across. I don't think he meant to make that pass. If he did, Zekov, way to go, my man.
Yeah. As always, I kept seeing there's certainly plenty of red for Carolina, but every time we showed shots behind the Capitol bench, as always, Cap fans traveling down to Raleigh doing a great job of supporting their team, preseason or not. DiGiuseppe winds up, and whoa, that was a brave block by Lucas Johansson. It's a tough way to end a game with a hard shot. But Lucas Johansson stood tall there as the horn goes. And from start to finish, it was all Carolina. They got the first two goals of the game. They finished with the last three goals of the game. Sandwiched behind one tally by Nicholas Backstrom. Ilya Samsonov played the third period. Braden Holtby the first two. And Washington remains winless in this preseason as they fall to 0-5 with a matchup with the St. Louis Blues on the road coming up.